Okay, hello friends, this is Yusuf here. Welcome to part 18 of Crash Course RPG League. So, we were doing the part 17 last time, right? So, which is the introduction to the subfile. And then I was thinking to make a separate video for each different type of subfile. Then I was thinking in order to redo the same stuff, right? I just add the existing videos link in the playlist so that you can just view it so that we can directly jump into the project. So the first update is actually, this is the playlist which I'm currently updating. Okay, so this is a part 17 which we have done last time. And after that, I'm suggesting to view the next four videos in this below order, just like how to create basic loadal subfile, and then how to handle the RRN using subfile record number in the loadal subfile, and then adding the record into PF using subfile, which means getting the input from the user and then adding a record into the physical file, and how do we update a record into the physical file as well. So once we have done this, right, we pretty much know how do we handle the PF using a subfile, basically. Okay, display, edit, and add those steps. So with this in mind, right, I was thinking about creating a simple project. I was thinking too much. I didn't want to complicate stuff because it's a beginner friendly tutorial. So I want to have a simple CRUD operation. Okay, CRUD, create, read, update, and delete. So with that, I have come up with this particular thing. Okay, so again, we're going to deal with something called student management, but this project should eventually give us an idea of how this subfile and then RPGLE together works. Okay, so if you are a beginner level, if you are able to do this particular thing without anybody's help, then that's the success of our crash course. So what we are going to do here, so basically it's a student management system, but here we have two steps. One is actually a admin page and then the user page. Okay, maybe I can say instead of user, student. Okay, so it's like the first screen, it will ask you whether are you admin or are you a student. Okay, and then if you give admin or student, based on that you should give you have to log in with the user ID and password. Then it goes to the second screen. Okay, if you are admin user, you should be able to see these four options. One, you can just display all the view all the students, or you can just add a student, or edit a particular student, or delete a student. Okay, but in case if you are a student, once you log in as a student, right, you can view your student and also update your some of the records. Okay, this is what we have planned. So as far as the table is concerned, as of now, I have come up with this particular two tables, but it might change once I start coding. Okay, so here is two major tables. One is the users and then students. So users are actually the used for password management. Okay, so either it can be an admin or a student, but all the user ID password will be available in this particular file. Okay, using this only, we will validate and then authenticate. And we'll be having a separate PF for holding student related information, something like ID, name, department, address, email, phone, etc. Okay, so this is a basic template of our project. So this video, I just wanted to discuss only about this upcoming project videos. And also going forward, right, it took some time for me to make this video because I held up in some other issues also officially. Okay, and also normally while making a video, right, I'll spend time to think and then do it by myself first and then redo it again. Okay, but this time, since that takes time, right, I'm just going to write from scratch. Okay, so whatever it takes, either I could make mistakes or not, doesn't matter. I'm just going to write it from the scratch. Okay, so let's see how it goes, so that you may find this video different from the what we have seen till now, but it will be a fun and enjoyable one. Okay, so that's it for this video. This is for the overview one. I'll see you in the next video. It's going to be a part 18.1 might be. Okay, we'll start creating our projects. Okay, so hope this this will give us an understanding of how a simple project will look like into the with RPGL and subfile together. Okay, so see you soon in the next video. Thanks for watching.